As you can see, I have a different microphone here, and this is my Tascam DR40, and it is a recorder that I sometimes use to record my audio, but it's also a microphone. It has these capsules here, and I've been wanting to test it out as a microphone for a while, so I thought tonight we could do that, and I thought what better way to test it than with this blue sponge, and some cling film or plastic wrap. I'm going to do some sponge scratching and squishing and some crinkling, and then I'm going to do some direct microphone tapping and scratching, which is something that ASMR Blossom does a lot on her channel, and it's one of my favourite. She's amazing at it, so if you like the microphone touching, then I'd recommend checking out her channel, because she gives me a lot of tingles. So this microphone is not as sensitive as my Zoom microphone, but the capsules on it, the ones on the Zoom are in an XY configuration, so they don't pick up the sound as ear to ear. Whereas this one, you can flip these out so they point that way. You can also flip them inwards, which doesn't work so well for the kind of ear to ear thing. And I have these. Cleaner things, holding them in place here because the sponge isn't quite wide enough to put it on when they're flipped out, but I will flip them out at the end and maybe it'll be a little bit more binaural or ear to ear. Yes. So if you're wondering what this is, or why I have this here, that is why. I also have had a few requests lately for kind of microphone handling, and a subscriber of mine has been asking if I have a Tascam for a while, so this is for you, Wolfie. And I haven't really tested it that much, so I'm not sure of the sound, so this is just gonna be a test video. And you can tell me if you prefer the Tascam for the sponge, or the Zoom, all the 3DO because I have done sponge mic with the 3DO as well. The thumbnail was terrible for it, but I think it sounded quite good. So yeah, and then I'll do a no talking sponge mic because I've only done one no talking sponge mic. Because every time I did a sponge mic video, I was testing things, so I thought it makes more sense to talk and explain what I'm doing, maybe. And I really like videos like this where people kind of ramble while testing things out. I don't know. I like it, so. Yeah. So let me know your preference for the next sponge mic, which will be a no talking one. Also, I'm not going to do the hair mousse in this video because I have another video planned for fizzing sounds, so I don't want to do too many in a row with fizzing, so we're just going to do scratchy and tapping crinkling sounds. Okay, so we'll start with the sponge. I also have my snazzy and ridiculous looking headphones that I bought specifically to use on your ears. And I think they look better on your ears than they do on mine.
Thank you.
going to remove the sponge now and do some direct microphone tapping and scratching and just touching in general. Okay. Taken these little fluffy things off, so I'm going to flip the microphones out. Like so. And now you can get a better ear-to-ear effect, I think. So I'm going to do some tapping.